Good morning, I'm Steve Sanders.
And I'm Allison Payne. Thank you for joining us.
Steve is a rare television writer in that he has the mind of a poet.
In a city of legendary journalists, Roy Coe was among the best, a poker-faced, bare-knuckle newspaper columnist.
And he's a fabulous writer.
The perfect example is the story we did on little Emily Bear, a little six-year-old piano player. He called me up very excited and he said, "What do you think of this?"
This is the story of a little girl who was born with a gift. And she opened that gift early.
When you're working on a Steve Sanders story, you feel like you're doing something better.
When you feel comfortable with someone, you let it all out.
And so many wonderful people.
The people of Honor Flight Chicago.
Don't be eating on camera. Come on now.
You can tell from his accent, Steve Sanders is not from Chicago, but he is from Illinois. Steve still owns this farm in Crossville that's been in the family since the 1840s. He likes to say he grew up with one foot in the Midwest and one in the South, but it's those Southern roots that shaped who he is.
Where are you from? You're from Mississippi, Louisiana, Alabama, Southern Illinois. Deep down, I think he wants to be African American.
Steve mostly grew up in Birmingham, Alabama, the second of Bill and Gladys Sanders' four kids. Steve's aunt and uncle lived a couple doors away from the Presleys in Memphis. Yes, the Presleys. That's Elvis's dad, Vernon, entertaining the Sanders boys.
Steve, what does it look like now?
Thank you, Carl.
He got his shot at TV in 1979 and occasionally did traffic reports for extra money. It almost killed him. A new helicopter pilot ran out of fuel and they crashed.
Well, I've raised a lot of eyebrows before.
You've made a career out of that, haven't you?
Steve worked hard and learned to write, covering everything from George Wallace to weeds.
One thing's for certain, if people could eat kudzu, the world would have no hunger problems.
Kudzu and karma led WGN to call in 1982.
Good evening. Denise Cannon is on vacation. Steve Sanders is with us tonight.
At first, he was a fill-in anchor, but mainly a street reporter.
Well, it took 18 minutes for John Wayne Gacy to pass away.
One of his proudest moments was a series called Dead Giveaway, about county employees ripping off the deceased.
And all of them are bad people, and they all should end up in jail.
Mary Field was his producer.
He taught me that good writing really matters. Even in a story like Dead Giveaway, which was based not even on records, it was based on what was missing from records, you could find a way to tell it that would bring viewers into the story.
Steve also started a family in Chicago, the proud father of daughter Lauren and son Tyler. The hardest story he'll ever tell is Lauren's death at age 6 from a congenital neurological disorder. But Tyler, the Sanders clan, and music got him through it. You'd think a main anchor in the third largest market would be the Sanders family success story. Sister Cindy is a college instructor in Monroe, Louisiana. Brother Chip is a wonderful songwriter and pianist. And baby brother John played on a Grammy-winning John Lee Hooker album. He still performs regularly from his home in British Columbia. Truth be told, we hope someday Steve may take those writing talents and turn them into songs, becoming what he's always really wanted to be, not a TV star, a rock star.
Thank you.